The hymn writer said, it's not an easy road we're traveling to heaven. Many are the thorns on the way. The Lord Jesus said, in this world, ye shall have tribulation. But there are those of God's people that do not find this easy to accept and are certainly discouraged by that thought. When you read the 11th chapter of the book of Hebrews, it's called Faith's Hall of Fame. But these were just ordinary people like you and me who conquered through faith. Now their faith was tested, but they came through. They ran the race that God gave to them. They weren't perfect, but they ran it. They proved that God's grace was sufficient, that God remained faithful to them as they ran it. And then at the end of it, they received the crown of righteousness, which God has promised to his redeemed people. And when we move to the 12th chapter of the book of Hebrews, it opens with the word wherefore. We're compassed about with this great cloud of witnesses. Now, these are not spectators that are watching you and me running the race, but they have left a testimony behind that ought to cheer us, that ought to inspire us and motivate us to run the race, because this is our day. And that's what it says here. Wherefore, let us. This is your day, my friend, and mine. We have got to run the race that God sets before us, and we have got to stand up and be counted in this day and generation in which we live. But to do this successfully, there are things that we must do. Now, a runner in a race must exercise discipline and effort and self-control and focus. Half-hearted runners will never really qualify for the race, never mind win it. Let us what? Let us lay aside every weight. Now, here's something we've got to cast aside. Now, marathon runners, they will watch their weight because they know that excess weight will hinder them in running the race. And anything that hinders us in growing stronger in our relationship with the Lord, we have got to cast them aside because they're hindrances. Now, they may not be evil of themselves, but if they hinder our fellowship with God, they are distractions and we are to deal with them. You know, they could be simply good things in themselves, friendships, work, sport, not evil. But if they stop us in our time and spending time with God, consuming that time, then they're hindrances. And we've got to lay us aside and lay them aside. And then it says, the sin that doth so easily beset us, we're to lay that aside too. Now, this is very particular. It's not the sins, it's the sin, the besetting sin. Is there some sin in your life, my friend, that raises its ugly head and you find it hard to get victory over or to master in your lives? It could be sins of the flesh or the eye or the pride of life. I don't know what it is, particularly for you, but whatever it is, you've got to deal with it. You've got to lay it aside. Don't put yourself in the position or the place that will aid your fall. In Bible times, men, they walked in long flowing robes, but you couldn't run the race. You would easily trip. They would entangle you. And there are things that would easily entangle you. That sin, you've got to cast it aside. And then let us run with patience. Now, let us run. Patience means endurance under circumstances. This is not a sprint. This is a marathon. So therefore, we are to endure. We are to run the whole race. You know, sad to say, there's some people and they start the race well and with great expectation, and then they get discouraged and they quit along the way. Have you done that, my friend? In God's name, get back into this race and run the race, and God will help you finish it well. Run the race that is set before you. That's what it says here. You know, the Olympic runners do not decide where the Olympics are held. They don't decide what city it's held in. They don't decide what lane they run in. They don't decide what time the race starts. No, because they are runners. Others decide. God is the person, my friend, that sets the circuit, whatever it be. And God is the one that sovereignly has set the course for you. Don't run somebody else's race. You have got to run the race which God has set before you, and do it with patience, with endurance. But you say, well, how can I do it successfully? A It says, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. And Paul brings the Lord Jesus as the motivation, because he says, look to him, keep looking continually. That's what the word looking means. Keep looking continually to him. McShean said, for every look to man, take 100 looks to Jesus. Because the Lord Jesus, when you consider him, remember that he finished the work and he did it with joy. My brother and sister, in God's name, you're in a great race. Run it today for God and run it successfully. Looking to Christ, he'll give you the victory. If you look to man, he'll disappoint you. But the Lord will never disappoint you. May God bless you as you run the race. Heavenly Father, bless thy people as we run this race today for Jesus' sake. Amen. From my heart to yours, home to yours. God bless you.